king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Have you heard the story about my friend King Dave? Wouldn't let the giant stand in his way. Said, hand me my sling, cause he's not that tall. My God is bigger and I'll watch him fall. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. And I heard the one that this guy called Dan. He was a holy, holy praying man. Said, throw him to the den of the scary beast. Save the hero from the lion's den. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of man. This is more than history. He will do the same for me, like Jonah and the whale at sea. When he's lost and afraid, all alone in the dark, you're with me. You're with me.
Singing in your praise. Hey, Kids Crossing, it's me, it's Mr. Bill. Happy Sunday morning. Today, we are learning that God is joyful. I am so glad you are here. Joyful, joyful, Lord, we adore thee. God of glory, Lord of love. Sing along. Hearts unfold like flowers before thee. Fill us with the light of day. Music can bring a lot of joy. And we're going to be reading in a couple of places in the Bible today. We're going to start in Zephaniah chapter 3, verses 16 and 17. Since we're learning today that God is joyful, let's talk about joy. What brings you joy? What do you think brings God joy? It might surprise you to know that the thing that brings joy to God, it's us. Right? From the very beginning, from Genesis chapter 2, right? He says it's very, very good, and he delights in us, his creation, in us. Since we're talking about joy, let's see if you can pass the joy of laughter. Now, I'd love to hear some jokes. I know my Sylvie knows some doozies. Like, she's really working on her, how does the chicken cross the road, or why the chicken cross the road, or who the chicken cross the road with. But it makes you laugh because she's trying to tell a joke. Tell me about someone that makes you laugh. One thing I know is that laughter is contagious. Once you start, you can't stop. Now, this week, I want you to dig into Scripture, and I'm going to give you 5 activities to do throughout the week. And I'll share them with you again on Facebook so you can read them and just give them a try. I want you to try one a day. It's a little bit of homework since school is out. Okay? And if you can share some pics of the joy that you're sharing with your family on Facebook, oh, that would be awesome. Okay? So first activity, joyful music. I want you to listen to a song that makes you smile. Or better yet, you could write a song about what makes you smile, or how you make God smile. Listen to Zephaniah 3, 16 and 17. It says, on the day of the announcement to Jerusalem, there will be On that day, the announcement to Jerusalem will be, "Cheer up, Zion! Don't be afraid, for the Lord your God is living among you. He is a mighty Savior. He will take delight in you with gladness. With his love, he will calm all your fears. He will rejoice over you with joyful songs." Is it cool to think that God sings over us? Like, he's got great songs, and that's why we like the songs we like to sing, because they come from him. So activity number one, sing a song that makes you smile. Listen to songs that make you smile, or maybe even write a song that makes you smile and share it with me on Facebook, okay? Activity number two is a treasure hunt. In Luke chapter 15, I'm just going to look at my notes. In Luke chapter 15, verses 8 through 10, it says, "Suppose a woman has 10 silver coins and loses one. Won't she light a lamp and sweep the entire house and search carefully until she finds it? And when she finds it, she'll call to her friends and neighbors, say, 'Rejoice with me, because I have found my lost coin.' In the same way, there is joy in the presence of God's angels when even one sinner turns to him." So here's what you want to do. Set up a treasure hunt for your parents or your brothers and sisters to find around the house. Or better yet, play hide and seek. And celebrate when you find the object. Celebrate when you get found. Isn't it so nice to know that God is looking for us like somebody who lost something valuable, right? He wants to know where you are, and he celebrates when he finds you. He wants to be with you. All right. So activity number three, okay? It's called Lead Me. It's from the book of Psalms, chapter 37, verses 23. And it says, The Lord directs the steps of the godly. He delights in every detail of their lives. See if mom or sister or brother will let you blindfold them. And then lead them around the house, right? Just as God leads us. And then it's your turn to wear the blindfold. Cool? All right. So activity number four is called Spacious Places. It's in Psalms again, this time, chapter 18, verses 19. And it says, "He led me to a place of safety. He rescued me because he delights in me." Now, I want you to build a comfy, cozy place in your house if you don't already have one. I'm talking pillows and blankets, if it's okay to have a cup of water or something cool to drink, right? And draw pictures of the places that God has taken you or the places he's going to take you, okay? Maybe there's some spot in the Rocky Mountains you've always wanted to go to, or you're looking forward to going to the beach because it's summertime, right? God is in all of those places, and he leads us to those places. Right? So beautiful places, spacious places. That was number four. And number five, it's time to dance. That's right. I want you to have a dance party. One of my favorite verses in the Bible is about David when he danced, bringing the Ark of the Covenant back to Jerusalem. It's one of my favorite verses. Anyway, check it out. But I want you, right now, we're going to listen to Psalm 149 verses 3 to 5. It says, "Praise his name with dancing, accompanied by tambourines and harps. For the Lord delights in his people. He crowns the humble with victory. Let faith rejoice that he honors them. Let them sing for joy as they lie on their beds." I think he's talking about having a dance party that goes all the way till bedtime. But your family can decide when they're going to dance. But have a dance party, right? Celebrate. God gave us the ability to move and to dance, so use it. Do as much or as little as you want with anyone who will play along. Experience joy together with your family. How does it feel to know that God has joy when he thinks of you? Some people think that God is angry and he's judging us for all the bad things we do. It's true that God doesn't like it when we don't obey, but God still loves you, and he has joy because you believe in him. God is joyful because we are his children. The best part is when we realize how much delight God has in us, we can't help but be joyful too. I love you. Share with me on Facebook all of the fun that you're going to have this week, and I'll catch you on the flip side. I got the joy, 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 joy. I got the joy, 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 joy. I got the joy, 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 joy.
And in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Oh, you are the peace in my troubled sea.
The silence won't let go. Thrown to the den of the scary beast.
got Dave to hear from the Lion Sea. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. Do the same for me, like Jonah and the whale at sea. When I'm lost and afraid, all alone in the dark, you're with me. Oh, you're with me, yeah. My God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the lions. My God's the king of the creatures of the deep. My God's the king of me. I said, my God's the king of the giants. My God's the king of the said, my God's the king of me.